He opened his mouth, and the Lord filled him with the spirit of wisdom and understanding, and clothed him in a robe of glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to hear the prophet of God, Lord, have mercy. You came to poor sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made the bishops and elders a teacher of the Catholic faith and a model of apostolic courage, raise up in your church men after your own heart to govern her with courage and wisdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Justice shall march before him, and peace shall follow his steps. Lord, our God is coming to save us. Alleluia, alleluia. Prepare a way for the Lord. Make his heart straight, and all mankind shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus was teaching one day, and among the audience there were Pharisees and doctors of the law who had come from every village in Galilee, from Judea and from Jerusalem. And the power of the Lord was behind his works of healing. Then some men appeared, carrying on a bed a paralyzed man, who they were trying to bring in and lay down in front of him. But as they loved made it impossible to find a way of getting him in, they went on to the flood roof and lowered him and his stretcher down through the tiles into the middle of the gutter in front of Jesus. Seeing their faith, he said, "My friend, your sins are forgiven you." The scribes and the Pharisees began to think this over. "Who is this man talking blasphemy? Who can forgive sins but God alone?" But Jesus, aware of their thoughts, made them this reply: "What are these thoughts you have in your heart? Which of these is easier to say? Your sins are forgiven you, or to say, get up and walk? But to prove to you that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralyzed man, "I order you, get up and pick up your stretcher and go home." And immediately before their eyes, he got up and picked up what he had been lying on, and went home, praising God. They were all astounded and praised God, and were filled with awe, saying, "We have seen strange things today." The Gospel of the Lord. This account from Luke's Gospel gives us a beautiful demonstration of how we should behave towards other people. It gives us a beautiful demonstration of an attitude that is expected by Jesus for us towards our brothers and sisters, towards our neighbor. Not the attitude of the Pharisees, no, but the attitude of the men who lowered their friend in front of Jesus. Initially, they could not find space to bring their friend in front of Jesus, but they were determined to make sure that he gets in front of Jesus, to get their friend in front of Jesus. They had to move tiles, they had to move everything in order to get their friend right by Jesus. They would be stopped by nothing and no one to bring their friend to Jesus. And the touch that Jesus does to the friend changes his life completely and for the better. My dear friends, our actions, our words, our attitude must be the ones inspired by the spirit of evangelization. They must be the actions and the words and the attitudes that will bring people closer to God, not the attitudes that will bring people away from Jesus. It is for all of us who have been baptized, we have received a mandate to bring people closer to God, to bring people in front of Jesus. So we must take care when we speak. We must take care when we act. And we must take care when we behave or present our attitudes in front of people. Otherwise, those things may drive people away from God. Because, yes, people are bound to judge us by what we say and do. And they want to reconcile our behavior, our attitudes, our words, our actions with that of the one we preach, Jesus Christ. We can't put Jesus on one hand and act differently on the other. It will confuse the world. In this time of Advent, we prepare to receive Jesus in our hearts, not to just keep ourselves warmed up by the love of Jesus, but that we may spread that warmth of Jesus' love to others. We do have a mandate, you and I, to spread the good news.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your grace we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your grace we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, to become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we celebrate the divine mysteries, O Lord, we pray, may the Holy Spirit fill us with that light of faith by which He constantly enlightens and ours for the spreading of your glory. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is really right and just, our truth and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for as on the first of our Sedanus, you bid your church rejoice. So too, you strengthen them by the example of His holy life, teach them by His words of preaching, and keep a safe in answer to His prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without help, we are here. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our.
At the time he was betrayed, he attended willingly into his passion. He took bread and gave it thanks for it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take it, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that your Lord is worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, and John our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, so we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, and all these saints that bless you throughout the ages, may merit to enjoy your eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever. As a service command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we all be free from sin, and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, and peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen.
would like to invite those who are joining us on Facebook at this moment to make your own apostolic communion. For the rest of us, I'm going to bring communion to you. So please do not move. Stay in your places. I'm going to bring communion to you. I'll come as close as possible, and you can extend your hands as far away as you. Ye who ponder the law of the Lord day and night will yield fruit in due season. Let us pray. Lead us who have been strengthened by the power of this sacrament, O Lord, so to profit from the teaching of St. Ambrose, that hastening fearlessly along your paths, we may be prepared for the delights of the eternal banquet through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you all for joining us in the celebration of the Eucharist today. On your way out, you go through the transept. It's still the one-way system, so you come out and just following the arrows. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.